Korea's viewers, I'm Lee Hae-sung. Do you like coffee and chocolate? I love them. But did you know that one day we may not be able to enjoy these delicacies anymore? The reason is climate change. Today on Korea's Focus, we are going to talk about climate change. Let's welcome our guests. Hello.
Hello everyone, bonjour. I'm Julian Quintot. It's been 20 years I live in Korea. And I'm a TV personality that's trying to use his voice to raise a bit more action around climate change.
Hello, my name is Liam Park, and I served as the co-leader of the Global Youth Climate Organization called GYCC from 2022 to 2023. And I first cultivated a desire for climate youth and advocacy in this area when I first attended a Model United Nations debate competition on this topic. I realized that there's so much to learn and there are possible solutions. So I'm very excited to be here today. Thank you.
Hi, nice to meet you. My name is Yoon Kyung-yeom. Then I will serve as a co-leader for GYCC, like Leon, for 24-25. I was able to get an interest by researching about the interaction of climate and human health. Then I'm raising a voice as a representative of youth right nowadays.
So I heard that GYCC is an organization dedicated to finding ways to respond to climate change. So could you tell us more about it?
Yes, of course. GYCC is short for Global Youth Climate Challenges. And it is an organization where we collect youth from all over the world and we create action plan models as well as policy proposals. And it was an initiative that was started by the UN former Secretary General, Mr. Ban Ki-moon. Oh. So we are very grateful to continue these efforts worldwide together.
Julian, is it true that we might not be able to enjoy chocolate one day because of the climate change?
Yeah, unfortunately, it's maybe true. Belgian chocolate is one of my favorite part about my country. Uh-huh. But yeah, actually what's happening is that because the climate is warming and so the farmlands where they used to be able to grow chocolate now, because of the heat waves, they're not able to grow as much chocolate as they used to. Same goes for like coffee and sugar. Climate change might really affect some of the things that we take for granted. And so these days people are also talking about like sugarflation. Or like heatflation, or also eggflation. Prices are rising because there's less and less production happening.
Yeah, think of launchflation. Oh. Yeah, I'm experiencing that recently. The price of launch manuals skyrocketed.
I also wanted to pitch in and say climate change really affects most vulnerable groups. And so this situation that is happening right now with these food shortages is going to damage the lives of those who are the most affected economically.
The UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres announced last July that the era of global warming has ended and the era of global boiling has arrived.
Climate change is here, it is terrifying, and it is just the beginning. The era of global warming has ended, the era of global boiling has arrived.
This year, every month also has been the hottest year in history. So in July, it was the hottest July in history. Korea was still kind of okay compared to some other countries. Mm-hmm. But still, it was one of the hottest year recorded in history. And then in September, in Belgium also, was the hottest year in history. And then this October also has been the hottest year in history all around the world. And so what's happening is that this year is pretty much already gonna be the hottest year that we ever experienced.
Like it's a new record every year.
Yeah, and it's not a record that we're happy to break, you know? What people don't understand actually that this might also link to more natural disasters.
We are able to hear like some news from like wildfire in Canada, Hawaii, or Southern Europe.
Now typhoons happening to Korea have becoming stronger and stronger. Once the whole temperature rises, so many things that totally changes in the systems that have been in place in the system Earth. You know, when we heat water, it evaporates more. Yeah. The same goes for actually seas. And so the sea gets warmer, then the more evaporation is happening, the more water keeps going up, and so typhoons get stronger. And also for forests, for example, I didn't know that, but the Amazon forest is almost impossible to burn normally. because the Amazon forest is like 80% of humidity. But the thing is that because now, because of global warming, the humidity is going a bit lower. And so now a forest that normally cannot burn because it's too wet, it has to face more and more fires happening there.
Wow, I didn't know that.
There's so many things linked to it. One thing is that we're losing actually what's helping us fight against climate change. For example, forests, usually, they've been a very natural barrier against floods or even droughts because they create humidity and also because the roots go deep into the earth. So they help water going actually inside the land. Mm-hmm. But once there's like forest fire, we lose this barrier. And then because it's burning, carbon dioxide that's releasing in the air. Yeah, one of the things is that glaciers actually are helping us to fight against climate change because actually white reflects heat. And in many countries like Greenland or those places where glaciers are melting, they reveal like earth and like land that's darker, right? And so usually the heat used to come here and be reflected. But now this heat keeps getting there also. So the thing is that it's really like creating a vicious cycle that's going there. And so it's been a big problem that we've been losing now many of those allies that have been helping us kind of fight against those natural disasters.
So the devastating effects of climate change seems to repeat themselves like a movie strip with no end or no beginning.
Korea used to have four very distinct seasons, but this summer was very, very long and it all of a sudden changed to winter.
Yeah, I really wanted to wear this very trendy like autumn jacket, but as soon as I put it on, I had to put it back in my wardrobe.
Seems like there are only two seasons, summer and winter. Nowadays, it went below zero, so Koreans are worried about cold waves. And ironically, I heard that this is also related to the warming of the polar regions.
Yeah, it's something that people don't really understand easily.
Yeah, and that's warming and cold waves?
Exactly. Because, you know, the whole planet is warming. But the thing is that in the glacier, especially in North Pole, there's something called the jet streams. It's really, really strong wind that turns around there and kind of keeps the cold weather in the North Pole. But as the whole planet is warming together, those streams are getting a bit more loose. And so they're not keeping the really cold air that's in the North Pole. So one time there was this episode in Texas where they had snow happening in Texas. And so many people don't really understand that actually the earth getting warmer can lead to some places getting colder.
So the word global warming could be misleading sometimes.
That's why some people actually have been advocating for using climate change.
Climate crisis or climate change. Mm. Well, thank you for the accurate explanation.
You're welcome. Yeah.
The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change recently estimated that the global average temperature increase will reach 1.5 Celsius by 2040. But 1.5 degrees does not seem like much considering the big temperature range of one day. So what does 1.5 degrees mean and what happens if the global temperature rises by 1.5 degrees?
Actually, I think that one good way to compare it is kind of compare it with our body temperature. So what's the regular body temperature?
36.5.
Yeah. What happens to your body when you like go 1.5 degrees more, 38 degrees?
We have to go to hospital.
And that's kind of the same. Our body can deal totally with like temperature changes from the outside world, right? Like if it's like 10 more degrees or 10 less degrees, we wear one more outfit, we take it out, and it's fine. But with our inner body, these small changes create some reaction changes that totally are gonna make us like go through a very hard time, and it's the same for actually climate. So the temperature of the weather that we experience in is totally different from the climate. And actually, climate of 1.5 is also an average number, right? It doesn't go the same way in every part of the world. And so we have to really understand that 1.5 is a very important point to respect. Actually, one of the achievements of the Paris Agreement is that we agreed to try to stay under 1.5 degrees. And they say that, unfortunately, once we reach this kind of, they call it the tipping point. Of 1.5 degrees, there might be some chain reaction that happened and will worsen. For example, in some of the glaciers, there's some methane or some other global warming gases that have been trapped. And at some point, those are gonna get released and they're gonna keep feedback loop of more and more warming happening after 1.5 degrees. But just one thing that we have to understand is that 1.5 degree is not the end of the world. We really have to fight stronger because 2 degrees is way worse than 1.6 degree or 1.7 degree. So we have to keep fighting for this. And one thing is that when we have temperature, we can take a medicine, but unfortunately, we didn't create a medicine for climate change yet.
So we really are in a climate crisis, and in the middle of such critical and urgent situation, countries around the world will be gathering to discuss ways to respond to climate change at the COP28 conference from November 30th to December 12th in Dubai.
COP actually stands for Conference of the Parties to the United Nations Framework Convention on climate change. The UNFCCC was started in 1995. And since its creation, it's been a very important time for all the governments to gather together, be able to discuss and to try to find ways and agreements to fight the climate issues. And one of the most important COP in history up to now was the COP21, because that's the one where all the countries agreed to try to stay under 1.5 degrees.
And I heard that you participated as a youth representative last year. So how was it?
Yes, actually, I did attend last year at COP27. And it was in Egypt. So I went there and I had the opportunity to talk to many global youth and present at a panel discussion with global climate experts in order to share and raise youth's voice on climate matter. So we actually got an opportunity to speak with other youth leaders that were advocating for this cause as well. And it was a very enriching experience. It inspired me to have more confidence in raising my voice as a youth. As I saw all the world leaders raising their voices, I found the need for more youth to also participate in the future.
So please tell us about the agendas and important prospects of the conference.
Actually, it's my first time to attend COP, so I'm really excited. They are planning to conclude the global stocktake, which is the first midpoint after the Paris Agreement. And also, they are planning to discuss about the operation of loss and damages fund agreed in last COP27. Also, they are discussing about the global greenhouse gas reduction goals, so I'm really excited to be there.
And I've heard that there's a lot of disagreement between developed and developing countries on what to include in the outcome document of the global stocktake, as well as who should contribute to the loss and damage fund and who should be eligible for it.
It is a complex agenda since it directly involves countries' industrialization and development.
Yeah, but the thing is that, climate change is not something that just one country can solve. And so I think it's international solidarity and working together is more needed than ever.
Under the goal of reducing greenhouse gas emissions by 40% by 2030, the Korean government has prepared detailed implementation plans. It is also implementing various policies to transition to a decarbonized economy. Moreover, President Yoon proposed a carbon-free alliance at the UN General Assembly last September. As decarbonization in the energy sector, which accounts for about 75% of emissions, is needed to combat climate change and achieve carbon neutrality, Korea proposed an initiative to the international community to increase the utilization of not only renewable energy, but also various carbon-free energy sources, such as nuclear power, hydrogen, and CCUS, and innovative technologies. In addition, as a responsible member of the international community, Korea will serve as a green letter to support countries that are vulnerable to climate change.
It's really good to hear. I really hope that Korea is not going to be known only for K-pop, but maybe for K-green
one day or so. I deeply felt the severity of climate crisis today. And how about you? How did you feel?
So today was really good to see that there's many people that are interested in these issues. I think one of the most important thing now is that more people need to know about it and we need to talk more about this issue.
I'm really moved by your enthusiasm.
I'm moved by their enthusiasm and yours too.
And how was it?
Well, it was such a great experience today to come and share about JOICC. As this is something that will affect the future of the youth the most and the future generations. So I believe that all youth have to be a part of this issue and be very involved and educated and try to do all the small efforts they can in their daily lives.
In the Book of Sapiens, the reason why humans are able to survive until the end and the rule of the world is because they are able to build a huge cooperative network based on the shared belief. So I highly encourage people who is watching this to pay attention and like raise awareness of theirs.
I think that to raise awareness, it would be great if you put a like, put some comments and share this video and say to this channel, please talk more about climate change in Koreas.
And I'm so relieved that our future generation, youth like you, are so much interested in environmental issues.
You're still part of the youth.
Am
yes.
I?
Yes.
Thank you for joining us today and educating us on the global climate crisis. And I hope that we can work together to slow down Earth's boiling temperature. Thank you for joining us today and see you next time. Bye.
Bye.